There were some broad categories of questions. We're going to try to lump some of them together and address. Gregory and many others obviously asked about the job situation. Many ask about the unemployment benefits. I think that we are really caught right at this moment in Washington. Most Americans are most concerned about the economy and jobs. But right underneath that concern is a concern about the debt and the deficit. So we've got to be careful. We've got to do everything we can to stimulate job production and protect the people who are unemployed through no fault of their own. But at the same time, we've got to begin to pivot and look at this debt and deficit. And it's trying to answer those two problems that is really the challenge at the same time. If we spend a lot more government money on trying to create jobs, then we're adding to a debt and deficit that could really hold down the amount of private sector job creation. So let me explain on the unemployment benefits. I do believe we'll get an extension on those unemployment benefits, and it will be retroactive, and it will be to the end of the year. But this will not go on forever. I think there will be an end in sight because, frankly, our country just can't afford to continue at the same level of funding that we have. On the other hand, as to jobs, so much of the stimulus continues to work as we speak. Thousands of jobs in Missouri, whether it's Kiel Auditorium in downtown St. Louis or the St. Louis Center or what's going on with high-speed rail between Kansas City and St. Louis, a broadband deployment, there is a lot of money that is actually getting into the stream of commerce right now and creating jobs from the stimulus. And let me point out one thing about the stimulus. Everyone has read about Governor Nixon cutting the budget in Missouri by $800 million. If it had not been for the stimulus and the money we sent directly to the states to save them and stabilize them, those cuts would have been billions of dollars. Your children would see larger class sizes. Teachers would have been laid off in much bigger numbers. So the stimulus, really, a third of it went just to stabilize the states. So as the people in Jeff City brag about balancing the budget, remember, they did it with the stimulus. They didn't do it with Missouri tax dollars. They did it with federal stimulus money. And then, of course, there was a big tax cut in the stimulus that continues to put money back in the pockets of 95% of Missourians as we speak. So I think we'll get some help on the unemployment, and we've got a small business bill that's going to help. We're not going to spend a lot of federal money on it, but what we're going to do is we're going to make some federal money available for loans. These small businesses that have made it through the rough patch, they're ready to grow. They just need credit. And if we can help provide some of that credit, we'll get paid back. And interest rates are low now anyway. This is not something that's going to cost the taxpayers a lot of money, but provide some needed capital to small businesses. That's the engine of the economy. That's where we're going to have the private sector growth, and that's going to really help in the coming months. It's going to be slow, but keep in mind, unemployment was at its lowest level in Missouri since April of 2009. And at the end of 2008, in the beginning of 2009, we were losing 600,000 jobs a month, 700,000 jobs a month, and we've had net job creation for the last 6 months. So we've turned the corner. The progress is slow and painful, but we're much better off today than we were a year ago.